Hi, I'm Liz from ARCA Space. On this week's episode, we'll be pressure testing the feed system conduit, and we also have an update on the launch decision.
As promised last week, we are going to inform you what the decision we took regarding the flight from Spaceport America. So we have two options. The first option is to go to 100 kilometers, apply for an FAA license, and this could take a lot of time. And the second option is to limit the engine run to 30 seconds and go to a lower altitude, approximately 25 kilometers, and in this case apply for a waiver with the FAA. And we decided to go to apply for a waiver with the FAA because if we limit the Demonstrator 3 to 30 seconds, in this case we can achieve an altitude of around 25 kilometers with the burnout of the engine at an altitude of 15 kilometers. In the first case, if we go to 100 kilometers, the burnout of the engine will be at 27 kilometers. So it's not necessarily a very big difference because the Aerospike engine will go from almost the sea level to more than 90% above the Earth atmosphere. So it's pretty relevant for the test of the Aerospike engine. We decided to also to follow this path because we don't want to get stuck into this development for the Demonstrator 3 rocket, which is a test bed, honestly, for the HAAS-2CA rocket. And we want to immediately after that to continue to focus on the HAAS-2CA rocket and to put this vehicle on the market as soon as possible. So, yeah, this is the decision that we took, and it's very relevant for the test, and also will allow us to move forward with the development of the HAAS-2CA rocket.
So here we have the setup for our feed system pressure test. We've got a pressure gauge, a pressure sensor, as well as a release valve to release pressure. Now what we'll be doing is we'll be filling this up with water and then pressurizing the rest with air. So we'll have our electric pressure sensor hooked up to our data acquisition system, as well as a camera recording the pressure gauge in order to make sure that both readings are consistent with each other. Now our release valve will be hooked up to a battery and switch so that we can release the valve at a safe distance.
Finalized the fourth test for the burst discs. During the first three tests we were not able to break the disc, but in the fourth test we broke it, and we know now, we decided what was the thickness of the burst disc, how many scratches we are going to apply, and what is the load with which we are going to apply the scratches on the disc. So as you can see, it's pretty good. We need to work more to have the scratches on the disc more uniform, and that's pretty much it. So basically when we are going to have the tank pressurized and we are going to release the pressure from the conduit, the burst disc that will be on both ends are going to break, and the hydrogen peroxide is going to enter into the injection head and from there into the engine. And so we are going to prepare the test article for new tests. to better define the burst disk and to have the final configuration.
That's all for this week's episode. See you next time on Flight of the Aerospike.